Filipinos are known to be a race that's always in love. Gentle, loving, caring, Filipinos are known to be some of the best lovers in the world. In the latest survey of the social weather stations, it was shown that 51% of Filipinos would choose a lifetime partner who is rich but ugly, rather than someone who's good-looking but poor. The same survey found that 5 of 10 Filipinos are very happy with their love life. 34% say it could be happier, while a low 11% or 1 in 10 Filipinos has no love life at all. Does everybody have someone destined to love forever? Or are there some really destined to be single for life?
Writer Jo Coudert sums single life so well. She says, you do not need to be loved, not at the cost of yourself. The single relationship that is truly central and crucial in a life is the relationship to the self. Of all the people you will know in a lifetime, you are the only one you will never lose. So we ask, can single life, whether you were never married, separated, or parted from your partner by death, be a good, happy life? As Oscar Wilde puts it, by persistently remaining single, a man or woman converts himself or herself into a permanent public temptation. Our question, can one be single and happy? You can join our discussion, text us, react, space, ANC space, with your name, address, and message, then send to 2331 for Globe, Touch Mobile, Bayan, and Sun subscribers, and 231 for Smart and Talks and Tech subscribers. And you can send us your tweets at twitter.com/ANC alerts and be a fan of Talkback with Tina Palma on Facebook. Now, who are with us in the studio, it does not necessarily mean that they are dateless tonight. The show is just going to be until 8 o'clock, so there's still enough time. We have someone who I have adored. Seasoned performer, theater artist, singer, comedian, and industry leader all rolled into one, and she's been single all her life, Mitch Valdez.
Hi,
nice
Tina.
To see you.
Hi. The intro sounds so self-centered.
Just for today. Also with us, beauty queen and really looking regal and still beautiful, turned actress and broadcaster, Evangeline Pascual.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy
to all
Valentine's
lovers and
to you.
At all.
Yes. And then we have TV host Jojo Alejar. He decided to marry late in life, and we will find out why. He was 39 when he tied the knot. And how old are you now?
What? Mid-40s.
So they also...
No, I married very late. I was talking about the time. It was 11 o'clock in the evening.
Okay, but you're mid-40s now. Yes. And we have, and to help us put our discussion in perspective, we have a counseling psychologist, Angie Sievert-Fernandez.
Hi, good evening.
Thank you very much. Is this a good show?
It's funny already.
It's funny already. But we have people who really are... at some point, the public knew about your life in terms of relationship. No? So we will begin with you, Jojo. You're such a happy person.
Oh, yes.
You are the only male, and we are all gentle women here. So we will let you have the
Please
floor.
Be gentle with me.
Yeah. Jojo, so you married at 39, and you're not late.
39, I married civilly. And then we decided to get married in church just last year.
Okay, but the first part of this story of our show is your love story. Where do I begin?
It's so funny because it's more like laugh story rather than love story. from the very beginning, I worked in Congress then. I stayed in the South Wing building. My wife-to-be worked in the North Wing building, but we met in the Senate. So what are the odds of us having the same bill pending in the Senate, and then that's where we met. And I was talking to my boss outside. We were just having this coffee break. And then she came out from the restroom. I was probing him, her from afar. And I couldn't get to her because my boss was always, you know, nudging me na on. Oh, na muna yan. Dito tayo for... But I wasn't always like that naman, you know. Mm-hmm. But anyways, when I saw her, I just knew that, you know, I just had to meet her. And then we were having supposed to be yung aming recap of what's happening, and as soon as we get back, we should know what we're supposed to be putting on the table. So it's supposed to be a serious discussion. And then she came out from the restroom, and then I just had to leave my boss and go to her.
Uh-huh. And what did you ask her?
I asked for her number, and she didn't give me her number.
She didn't.
She didn't give me her number. So I asked again, this time with force. Mm-hmm. You know, and nagulat siya eh. So talagang it was yung doing the proverbial element of surprise. So no, she gave me a number in call. I know that number eh. I'm talking about that thing hanging on your neck, that cell phone. It has a number. This one. So I was very persistent. So she gave it to me. And then from that time on, I was texting her and spending thousands upon thousands of
text messages.
You started counting the pesos. Huh?
Yes.
and then, what would the text be? Like asking her out or?
Yes.
Saying I love you or you or?
Oh, I was referring to her as my future wife, agad.
Already?
Yes. Tinamaan na.
Okay. So tinamaan na.
Yes. No.
At that first time that you met her, and the succeeding texts already was off telling her that she was going to be your future wife.
Well, that's part of the bola system, no?
You men.
But you know, yeah.
It worked.
Yung during the time that I was texting her and wanting to get close to her, that was part of the grand plan. Uh-huh. But true enough naman, that I was really during the getting to know.
So at the time you saw her, what hit you? It was the physical.
Well, now that we're married, I just
heard her talk or anything like that. You just saw her from afar, and she was your type.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yes. We'll leave it at that. Okay. We'll go to Evangeline. She's such a gorgeous lady.
Oh,
look at her.
Oh, yeah. I say thank you.
Thank you. What about you, if you care to tell us about?
Let me start with a liner that goes something like, it's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all.
Yeah? Who said that? Okay.
My husband passed away. And, you know, that's the lost part of the love story. But that doesn't mean that the shoe is too big to fit. And therefore, now I would say in my program that love is not a once-in-a-lifetime experience. So we have to embrace it and feel the warmth of a loving heart. Mm-hmm. For love is indeed incredibly beautiful, echoes of the heart. So I listen to the echoes of my heart now, meaning I do not live by that rule that people tell me, probably he was so good a man that you couldn't like replace him, that he's like the only one in your life. Yes and no, but why do I remain single? Did I experience bad things in life? So what happened in my life? Am I suffering still? Did I get bad treatment from men?
She's her own talk show host, okay? Asking the question. Go ahead. And answer the question.
Yeah,
I'm having
my own reflections on this when you threw us a question before the program began. Because it's been 17 years since that day when he passed away. And therefore, it's not the number of years, it's how you look after the many years. So it doesn't mean that the loneliness will remain there when the time that he passed away. That's my love story. I mean, I guess the love that we had shared together brings me forth to where I am now. So the love story is, it's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all. And it may be sad that he's no longer around, but it doesn't necessarily mean that I am unhappy.
Mm-hmm. Are you consciously trying to keep people
away from me?
Away from you, who you think are beginning to look at you differently? Like, you know, maybe Evangeline could
remarry
look or remarry.
Uh-huh. You know, the prime cut is like laid in front of me, and the red carpet still unfurled in front of me, but still. I think I fell in love with my work. I think I fell in love with my career. Career in relationship with my people who are
the followers.
You do a radio program.
I do a radio program for 16 years. Yes. My husband died 17 years ago.
Uh-huh, so that became your...
My romantic affair. And okay. I romance
it's
with
hard
my...
to romance a radio.
try it, baby. You see how unconditional the radio can become.
Wow,
yes.
With the karaoke system.
And therefore, if a radio can be unconditional, yours truly can be unconditional. In fact, I gave my mom a little...
The show is here. Okay.
A little I gave my mom a little, parang, a promise, especially my dad. Kasi, my dad, I'm talking about, I don't mean to sound morbid here, but a year after... 5 days before my dad passed away, his last words were like, anak, mag-asawa ka na ulit.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been like 15 years, mm-hmm. and I haven't obeyed my father. yeah, that's what I'm saying. Parang, it doesn't mean that I really have to like replace or get into a relationship away after
it.
A lost relationship. So it doesn't mean that parang, there's always loneliness that would be carrying me through these years, but it's like the attitude towards the love that I spent or we spent together that brings me on.
Yeah, Mitch.
Yes, Dina.
I don't have to ask you.
Where do I begin? Mm-hmm. No, I've watched you all these years on stage, and I remember distinctly one time you were, it was, I don't know if it was a Valentine show, and I was with some of my girlfriends, and the last song that you sung was the one of Stephen Bishop.
It Might Be You.
Yes. And that was the first time I ever listened to the lyrics of that song, Something's Telling Me, It Might Be You. And, you know, I just felt at that time that you were still looking or hoping.
Yes.